is Tyler Bertuzzi. He gets his stick. Oh, look at that. It's Bertuzzi's tip. It hits the leg of Lindholm. That puck is going about 10 feet wide. It's going to the corner. Bertuzzi's deflection hits the left leg of Hampus Lindholm, and the Leafs have tied the score. Maple Leaf Square revs up again.
Huge break for Toronto. You could see the despair for Lindholm. Bertuzzi will get credit for it. Oh, and a terrible turnover. Domi jammed it out in front. Boy, the Boston rookie defensemen have been a little shaky tonight, both Wotherspoon and Lorai. 2-2 the score. And as you said, Ray, that Bertuzzi tip was heading toward the corner, but it hit Lindholm's like, Marchand scores! Boston responds immediately! Brad Marchand makes it 3-2.
Talk about silence the building, and the fact that it's Marchand puts a blanket over everything in here. The Bruins captain came in to the game with 2 goals in his last 18 games. He's had a terrific series. A goal and 4 assists for Marchand. It starts on the cycle. And there is Danton Heinen, who has been really quiet in games 1 and 2. Heinen, a terrific pass. Marchand is standing alone. Oh, that's a perfect shot as well. Domi, half a stride late. The shot is over the glove, under the bar, and in 28 seconds, 2-2. Becomes 3-2 Boston. The Bruins get in on the forecheck. Frederick, pressure on Liljegren behind the net. Pressure by Heinen on Matthews. He wins the puck both from Matthews and Edmondson. And Marchand's shot is perfect. Starts with the pressure from Frederick, the pressure from Heinen, and the finish from the Bruins captain. And Vzáka wins it clean.
To Lindholm. Domi, I believe, broke his stick. And an attempt to go. McAvoy taken down by Tavares. There'll be a penalty. The puck goes to the empty net and hits the post. And as Marner plays it, the penalty is called. Very costly penalty against Tavares as he took down McAvoy.
Tavares is hot, as you might expect. Behind the net. The puck will spin out to Charlie McAvoy. McAvoy, who has had a monster night for the Bruins, over 25 minutes a game. He feels Tavares' pressure, his hand on his hip, and off he goes. The empty netter would have sealed it, but it hits
the inside of the post.
Inside of the pipe and bounces away. A timeout called. And so what Jim Montgomery's really talking about here is, yeah, the power play, that's great and all that. But how do we control the puck? How do we make sure we're in the right place to defend this lead? You do not have to shoot the puck. There's no reason to shoot it. A shootout or a shot becomes a rebound, becomes a turnover. Control of the puck is it. And for the Leafs, you've got to hunt the puck and try and get it off their stick so you can get Samsonov out of the net.
1:04 to go, a Boston power play. And Samsonov obviously will have to go back into the goal for Toronto.
One other thing to keep a note on, because the Leafs are shorthanded, they can just get the puck and shoot it down the ice. They can poach way down the ice. There is no icing for them. So you can get the puck, send it down the ice, and try and win a foot race as well.
Boyle's won 2 out of 3 tonight, head-to-head with Matthews. And he wins another, and it comes back to McAvoy. The cross, it goes to Lindholm. Pasternak for Coyle. Marner played it away to Riley. And they're going to pull Sampson off as they go up shorthanded. And Matthews lost it at the line to Marchand. Empty net and hit the outside. Just missed the right post. Chance to seal it perhaps. Pasternak hits the outside of the post. Marchand scores into the empty net. A power play goal for Boston. And a franchise record tying 55th career playoff goal for Brad Marchand, who's having a huge series.
Last year he came into the playoffs with 2 goals in 16 games, then scored 4 goals in 7 games against the Panthers. He's done the same thing again this year. 2 goals in 16 coming into the playoffs. And he's been brilliant in this first round. Charlie McAvoy stands up Matthews. McAvoy's had a fantastic game 3 here. Marchand hits the side of the net. Monty just can't believe it behind the Bruins net. He says, unbelievable. But 5 seconds later, Marchand knocks down Bertuzzi. Pastrnak hits the side of the net. And Brad Marchand will lock this away. Home ice advantage earned by the Leafs. Home ice advantage taken away by the Bruins.
55 playoff goals ties Cam Neely, now the Bruins team president, for the Boston franchise record. And he has 6 points, does Marchand, in these 3 games with 2 goals and an assist tonight. And Scotiabank Arena has emptied rapidly. Babushkin up the middle for Camp. He lost the puck at the line. They're not going to bother taking Samsonov out, down by 2. So this will be 5 games for Swayman against Toronto this year. All wins. None allowing more than 2 goals. Ray, if I were Jim Montgomery, the rotation would be over. What do you think?
I'm agreeing.